Now in this session, we are going to do a small screen design project by using linear layouts, weights and shapes. Consider this screen design. Now in this screen design, we are not going to design entire screen. Our responsibility is we will design only this portion, whatever I am marking with the pink color, this portion we are going to design. As of now, don't worry about header portion and don't worry about remaining body portion. We will discuss this later. Now try to analyze this body portion carefully, which we are going to design now. This is going to be a studio based project. I will be showing this project using Android Studio. Before writing this project, let me give some brief clues on how to do this project. If you observe carefully, first let us try to identify the shapes which we are going to design by using XML code. Observe this shape we are going to design by using XML code. If you observe carefully, these corners are slightly bent. For our convenience purpose, I will give the border color for this shape. Border color value is #dbdbdb and body color is white, and you can imagine the border thickness is 1 pixel thickness. So we are going to design this shape using XML code in resources and a drawable folder. Next background shape is, you can observe for this one, which is starting here and which is ending till here. That is also one more background shape. I will be giving border color for that also. The border color is #CBD2D3 and the body color is, this is border color, and the body color is #DFF0D8. And if you observe carefully, this background shape, it does not contain curved shaped corners. So probably if you want, you can give probably 1 pixel as corner. Probably you can give 1 pixel radius as corner. Now, if you observe this overall shape, I can divide this overall shape into 3 rows. This is first row, this is second row, and this is third row. In the first row, we have one text view, we have one checkbox, one image view, and one more checkbox, and one image view. Observe carefully, row 1 is horizontal linear layout with one text view, a checkbox, one image view, one more checkbox, and one image view. If you observe carefully the proportions, the width proportions for these 5 elements is 5:5:1:5:1. You don't have to do rocket science for this. Just based on your visible analysis, it looks like 5:5:1:5:1. Similarly, in the row 2, we have 3 text views. Again, if you observe the width proportions of these 3 text views, it looks like 1:1:1. But that is wrong, because we need one more slot for empty space. So if you observe carefully, second row actually contains 4 text views, where the last text view is in the invisible mode. I will show you how to create a text view in the invisible mode. It's very simple. After creating text view, don't give any text. It will be automatically, will not be visible. So in the second row, we have 4 text views with the width proportion, that is weight proportion, 1:1:1:1. Again, second row is a horizontal linear layout with 4 text views. Now observe third row. Third row contains one text view and one vertical linear layout which contains 2 text views, and again one more vertical linear layout which contains 2 text views and one button. Again, if you observe the width proportions of all these elements, it is 1:1:1:1. So that means for text view, you have to make width as 0dp, weight 1, and for this vertical linear layout, width 0dp, weight 1, and so on. Again, if you observe these 2 text views, their height proportion is 1:1. Here also, these 2 text views, height proportion is 1:1. Anyway, as of now, we don't know how to give rupee symbol and dollar symbol and a strike mark. So in this example, I am not going to discuss about how to give currency symbols and how to apply strike marks. For time being, we will display 11989 in the red color and 9991 in black color. Similarly, I will not represent dollar symbol. We will display 237 in red color and 200 in black color, without dollar symbol and without strike mark and without rupee symbol. And coming to this button, the button background color is equivalent to hash 337AB7. Again, if you observe carefully, this text view's text style is bold. I will also show you how to apply bold style for text views. This text view is also bold style. These are all normal styles. Only these are all bold styles. So we have four text views with the text style bold, and other text views are normal style. So this is the prerequisites. Can you guess what's the root element to design this body portion? Obviously, the root element is, if you observe, this body portion contains three elements which are arranged in one below each other. That means all these rows are touching y-axis. That is one below each other, which means the root element is vertical linear layout, which contains first row or first element as horizontal linear layout with one text view, two checkboxes and two image views. Second row is also a horizontal linear layout with four text views, where fourth text view does not contain any text. Third row is also one horizontal linear layout which contains one text view, one more vertical linear layout and one button. Again, in this vertical linear layout we have two text views. Again, in this vertical linear layout also we have two text views. Though this design looks very simple, it contains many layouts with many images and many predefined background shapes with a lot of weight combinations. So root element is vertical linear layout. Now let us start this project in Android Studio. Before this, the prerequisite is, I am going to give these two images, that is SD card image and pen drive image. You have to keep these two images in the drawable folder. You have to keep it ready. Before starting project, I will show you the actual picture of that image. The actual picture looks like this. We are going to design this body portion from this place to this place. Since we are designing only this much, what I will do, along with this vertical linear layout, just below this vertical linear layout, I will take one big text view with the height proportion 6. This height proportion is 4, and this height proportion I will take it as either 6 or 7. And slowly we will design this also in the later sessions. As of now, don't worry about header portion. This is called as action bar, which we will learn later. Now I have created a new project with name Screen Design Project. First prerequisite, I will copy these two images into drawable folder. Ctrl C, select drawable folder, Ctrl V, click OK. Now they are copied, SD card and pen drive image. The preferred format for predefined images is PNG images, that is portable notation graphics, which is the smaller size, which comes with very small size. Compared to JPEG and GIF and BMP, PNG image sizes are very less. In case if you want to take predefined images, preferably go with PNG images, as they come with smaller sizes. Now I will go to the root element of Activity XML. I will convert it as linear layout, and I will take orientation as vertical. I will remove existing text view. In this overall body, we are going to design this part. So this part I will take it as one more vertical linear layout and one text view. I will take one more linear layout with width match parent. Height I will give as 0 dp, and I will apply weight as, weight let us say 5, and just below this linear layout I will take text view with width match parent, height 0 dp and weight as 7, which means this body portion which we are designing in the vertical linear layout, I am maintaining height proportion as 5, and below text view, it is not text view, but for time being I have taken this portion as text view with height proportion 7. So we are not going to worry about this text view. Now we are going to design this body portion. Now let us see the brief preview. So this is our body portion and this is text view portion. First, let me take 3 rows as 3 horizontal linear layouts. What is the height proportion of all these rows? If you observe, first row, second row and third row, the height proportion is, it looks like 1:1:2, because this height is double the height of this height and this height. I am taking horizontal linear layout for first row, width match parent, height 0 dp, and weight 1. So this is for first row. If you observe carefully, it is giving error here, because as per our expectations, the root element should be vertical linear layout, but the root element I have not specified orientation as vertical, so I should specify orientation vertical, then it will remove this error. Now this is corresponding to first row, that is this row. For second row also I will take one more horizontal linear layout with width match parent and height, I will give the weight as 1:1:2. I will copy paste same linear layout, Ctrl C and Ctrl V, that is second row. This is first row. You can observe here, as the cursor is moving, it is highlighting different rows here. And I will copy paste one more horizontal linear layout for last row. For this last row, I should specify weight as 2. So finally, so this is our body proportion. First row, horizontal linear layout. Second row, one more horizontal linear layout with weight 1. And third row, one more horizontal linear layout with weight 2. Now let us proceed further. Now, first I will design first row. I will take one text view, one checkbox, image view, checkbox, image view. First, let us finish one by one. As I told you already, when you are given a complicated screen design, first you have to divide that into row by row fashion, then start designing with each row. So don't do everything in one shot, you may get confused. Now I'll go to first row. In this row, rather than dragging and drop, preferably it's better to type manually, because we don't know, when you drag and drop, it may sometimes jumbled up. So I prefer manually writing. So first I will take one text view. So we need a width proportion should be 5:5:1:5:1. So I will make width as 0 dp, height as match parent, and weight 5. And I will give text as, what is the text? Purchase width. Next element is checkbox. Checkbox width also 0 dp, height match parent, weight again 5, and text should be, what is the text of this checkbox? SD card. Now let me take image view, width 0 dp, height match parent, weight 1, and we have to put image source, that is drawable folder. First we have to put SD card image. So search for SD card, select that option which looks like that. Similarly, I will take one more checkbox, I will copy paste this, and I will change the text as pen drive. So next checkbox text is pen drive. Again take, just beside checkbox there is one more image view. So I will copy paste this image view one more time, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, and change this image from SD card to pen drive. So as of now, the first row is over, but the outcome is not coming as we have expected. Slowly I will adjust. So with this first row briefly over, now we will design second row. Once you put all elements, aligning is very easy. Now I will go to second row, where we need 4 text views, 1, 2, 3, and one empty text view with width proportion 1:1:1:1, width 0 dp, height match parent, weight 1. So here it should be course name. But core should come in one line, name should go to next line. How will you move this name to next line? Let me show you what I am trying to say. Now let us, I put here course name, Observe here, course name is coming in one line, but I want course should be in the first line, name should go to next line. In Java, we can use backslash n to move the content to next line. So I'm using same technique here. So that is the first text view. Then I will create second text view with the price in INR, price backslash n in INR. Sorry, it should look like this, price in INR. So backslash n says that go to next line, in the next line print INR. Similarly, price in USD, that is US dollars. And last text view with no text, because we need one proportion of empty space there. So I will remove that. Now you may be wondering what will happen if I remove this text view. Now observe, it is not coming as expected. So it is expected here, but this price in USD is moving towards right side. So we need some extra space there. For that reason, we have taken one empty text view, which looks like this. Now let us design fourth row. In the fourth row, we need one text view, one vertical linear layout with two text views, one more vertical linear layout with two text views, and one button. So let me type it. Again, proportions are 1:1:1. So because if you observe here, the width of this text view is one proportion, the width of this layout is one proportion, and this is also one proportion, and this is also one screen proportion. So I'll give width as 0 dp, height match parent, weight 1, text is C sharp for backslash n freshers. Next element is vertical linear layout, width is 0 dp, height is match parent, weight 1, and orientation is vertical. Again, in this vertical linear layout, we have two text views, one here and one here. Text view width match parent and height is 0 dp, because we have to distribute their heights in 1:1 proportion. Text is 11989. Next text view is 9991. Next text view comes with the content 9991. And the next element is one more vertical linear layout with two more text views. I will copy paste same linear layout, Ctrl C and Ctrl V, with the content 237 and 200.